Bienvenidos a Colombia.
Stand up like a soldier, baby. Yeah, I know you been like that. Gun it like a holster, baby. Show them say you're wicked like that. We live where the war is raging, chasing our crazy dreams, hoping that the bridge won't cave in. Tonight we'll let it all go free.
Springfield-Cape and YouTube. Hey, how's it going? Josh down here living in South America, more specifically Colombia. More specific than that, Boyacá. More specific than that, Villa de Leyva. Full address, Villa de Leyva, Boyacá, Colombia, South America. Hey. So, in case many of you didn't know, my summer assignment was to come down here and learn Spanish. Some of you have seen some pictures, some of you probably heard from some of my friends, probably seen watching the Facebook page, and that's awesome. That's awesome. So I've been here a month so far, and I have another month to go. So the purpose of this video is really just kind of show you what I've done this last month, kind of what we've been doing, cultural experiences, landscapes, culture, language, things like that. And I hope you really enjoy it because it's a ton of fun.
So I didn't want to start with class because that's kind of boring. So what we'll start with instead is one of our favorite activities, and that's hiking. So behind our village, kind of more specifically really behind the house, is a mountain. And up on this mountain, about halfway, is a statue of Jesus. And it's super popular with all the locals here and a lot of the tourists to climb up this mountain, mainly because of the views that it offers, the sense of accomplishment when you finally get up there. And we've climbed it at least 5 times now, and each time it just gets better and better. Some of the people you meet up there, some of the things, you know, you talk about on the way up, and really just like that whole experience. Looking down on where you live is beyond surreal. It's a little cliche, of course.
Hey, Springfield-Cape, we just climbed this mountain. Jacob and I and all those guys up there, and spent about 3 hours doing it, and we're at 9,700 feet, so about 2,800 feet up from our village, which is all the way somewhere down there, so it's cool. But now we gotta get down before it rains. We did it. We did it. Hey, so here in Villa de Leyva, we live in the Barrio de Estados Unidos, the neighborhood of the United States, or as we like to call it, the compound. And basically, it's me and 6 guys from the Archdiocese of St. Louis. We're living here. We have our house. This is where we have class every day, Monday through Friday. We eat here. We sleep here. We hang out here. It's kind of like our home base. So basically, classes are Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to noon.
So I realized that I can't keep talking about the Villa de Leyva unless you guys know something about it. And so here's a few things that you need to know. One, settled by the Spanish in 1556, probably one of the first settlements that the Spanish ever had here, which is kind of cool. Two, all the streets are cobblestone. We're not talking like, you know, oh, that's nice, one or two stones here and there. No, the whole dang thing is cobblestone. You get used walking to it, but it took us about a week. Next thing you need to know, it's kind of like a tourist trap. It's like the Branson of Colombia, mainly because it's old and because it's old.
Another one of the popular things around Villa de Leyva is its nightlife, and really just the whole town. So its nightlife is really kind of centered around the plaza. It's very family-oriented, it's very tourist-oriented, and it's very safe. So maybe that's, you know, go out and grab a pizza, sit and watch some people. Maybe it's get some ice cream with the guys. Maybe sit there and have a beer, anything. There's a ton of people always in there. It's the largest cobblestone plaza in South America, and it's awesome. It's really, really cool. And if you ever get a chance, I would recommend coming to see it. But here are some other things that they do at night around here.
This is for you.
Now for the real purpose of why we're down here, class. So class is held in our living room, and our teacher comes in every day, Monday through Thursday, to have class with us. We do have class on Fridays, but it's usually reserved for a cultural outing of sorts. Maybe it's a hike, maybe it's go visit a restaurant, a local restaurant, local shop, or something. So we'll give you a little insight, but be warned, it's not always this calm.
In singular or in plural, is there is or there are. The past tense is hubo, but now
hubo.
H-U-B-O. But today just learn.
Diablos! Todos son. La 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 la.
There is a purpose for us to be down here. We're not just down here to play, as I hopefully that video isn't showing you. That's all we're doing. We are down here to learn Spanish. And so in our classes, we learn. This first month was really kind of more recovery introduction, things that we've maybe have learned in the past or still learning, and then verbs and stuff. And so this last month of school has been us getting comfortable kind of being back in the classroom, comfortable with our teacher, and just things like that.
As I said earlier, we have class Monday through Friday. But Friday, we really don't have class because it's reserved for a cultural outing. So we've done things like rode the local bus system, traveled to Tunja to shop, seen other cities and plazas, and really just kind of learned how the cultural aspect, how that whole thing is very different than, you know, how it is in the United States. We can stop a bus on the side of the road and hop on it and just ride it somewhere. Sometimes we just go on hikes, and here's one example of one of those hikes.
At the farmer's market with the hermanos, and as you can see, it is quite crazy getting all the good foods for the week.
So the farmer's market, it comes to town every Saturday and is set up the night before and opens at 6 a.m. It then proceeds to run through 6 p.m., so 12 hours. What it basically is tents and people selling whatever they have.
So I want to go on record and I want to say, if I don't come back, it's not my fault. Mrs. Bishop Rice, this is your fault. You sent me down here. This was my assignment. That's really it for this whole video. I know that there's no way that I'm going to accurately be able to convey to you everything we've done. I know it's unfair, but hopefully I'll be sending out some more shorter videos, just kind of some things that we've done, maybe like a hike, maybe some one of our excursions through the town, some pictures and some videos of that. If you guys have questions, if you have things specifically you want to know or things specifically you want to see, let me know. I'm more than happy to go do those things for you, talk about them. Check back in a month, keep up with the Facebook page, and please, as always, pray for me and my brothers as we enter into this next stage of the summer, the second half, and we will do the same for you. Ciao, adios, rega por nosotros, ciao.